In this screencast, we want to look at how to use the Ping-Robertson equation state spreadsheet. In another screencast, we solve this problem where we compress a 9 ideal gas and conditions are given here, and we calculate a number of things, including volume and changes in internal energy and entropy. That screencast showed the values that we obtained from the spreadsheet. So here, we want to show how we obtained those values. So first, let's look at what those values were. For the temperature and pressure at the first state, we read the volume, the internal energy, and the entropy from that spreadsheet, and likewise for the final condition at higher pressure and the same temperature. And so the spreadsheet that we're using is from the textbook by Elliott and Lira. Here's the link to where you can download for free those spreadsheets. And let me lead you through the steps. They're fairly straightforward to do the calculation. So we're going to use the critical pressure, the critical temperature, and the eccentric factor, which are listed in the spreadsheet. There's a worksheet with critical properties, and we're just going to copy them and then paste them into the properties worksheet. So here we're looking at the critical properties worksheet, and I've modified the spreadsheet slightly to make things easier to see. So I've made the numbers bigger for carbon dioxide, and I've made it so we can scroll through and freeze that top. So we see what we're reading off is the critical temperature, critical pressure, and the eccentric factor. So I'm going to select these four cells, copy them, and then move to the property spreadsheet where now we happen to have nitrogen, and I'm going to paste them here. So now we have carbon dioxide values for critical pressure, temperature, and eccentric factor. When we did that, if we look at the reference spreadsheet, it also copied the values into the reference spreadsheet. So that's the first step. The second step is to copy the parameters for the heat capacity from the ideal gas heat capacities worksheet and post that also in the properties tab. So I'm going to select the ideal gas heat capacities. Again, I've modified this to make it easier to see. So I'm going to copy. And what I'm going to copy is just the four values and then go to the properties and the heat capacities for those four values. The heat capacity parameters are copied here and it now calculates values, calculating for 300 degrees and 1 megapascal at present. So it says the next step is to pick the reference temperature and pressure on the reference state spreadsheet. So in the reference state spreadsheet, I'm going to pick 230 and 1/10 of a megapascal. It doesn't have to be these values, so let's just use those. And then the one other thing that's important is this 2 in this column that corresponds to the 2 here. And so that means it's using these conditions as the reference state. The 2 tells which of these three. This value is the vapor, liquid, and then if there was only one solution. So we have to pick a number here where there are entries in the table here. And so 2 works fine for this. As long as we're consistent in our reference, we're going to be able to calculate the properties. And so now we'll go back to the properties worksheet. And we input the temperature and the pressure that we're interested in the properties worksheet, and then we're going to calculate all these values, the volume, specific volume, internal energy, enthalpy, fugacities, and departure functions are all calculated. So the temperature in Kelvin, 448.2, the pressure, 20 bar, which is 2 megapascals. I'm going to read the volume off this, the volume I showed you earlier. This is U in joules per mole, so 19.6 kilojoules per mole. And then this is entropy. Notice also it calculates fugacity. And these values on the right side, these values right here, correspond to the departure functions. The value of enthalpy minus the ideal gas enthalpy value, likewise for internal energy and entropy. And then the final thing would be to calculate at the final conditions. which is the same temperature, but 275 bar, which is 27.5 megapascals. And now it calculates the new smaller volume and the internal energy changes because this is an ideal gas, and the entropy decreases because we've raised the pressure on the gas at constant temperature. And so this spreadsheet then allows us to calculate values for a large number of compounds that you see listed in the critical properties worksheet. And then we can use these in calculations where state functions allow us to calculate changes in properties.